Fear and anxiety have gripped some of the family members of people designated by the Philippines' Anti-Terrorism Council as terrorists. 19 names were published in newspapers. One of them is National Democratic Front peace consultant Adelberto Silva.
Siyempre, naalarma ang lahat, no, sa aming buong pamilya, at naglagay talaga yan ng isang fear din para sa kanilang safety at saka sa kanilang security.
Silva is currently detained along with two other fellow peace consultants, Vicente Ladlad and Ray Casambre. Casambre's daughter wonders why there's a need to designate individuals like her father, who is now in jail.
May ikulong na nila lahat. And kung ano pa man yung nandun sa bank, please pa nila. Parang naikulong na nila, di ba? Na-immobilize na nila. So what more is the state looking for? Talagang it's a continuation of its crackdown.
The Department of Justice and the Office of the Solicitor General had said designation only involves freezing of assets of designated terrorists. But their families ask, what assets will be frozen when they have barely enough?
Si Tatay Ray, I always tell friends pag nagkukwentuhan, para makapagpasalubong ng isang supot ng money kay nanay, pinipili niyang maglakad pa uwi imbis na mag-tricycle.
I will safeguard every centavo of VIX deposit in the land bank to BSP Government Benjamin Joklo. This is blood money. Don't be complicit in the McCarthy witch hunting spree of the Anti-Terrorism Council.
Despite an assurance from the Justice Department that no arrest will be made by virtue of the designation, families are not convinced.
You know, it's a matter of trust eh. Kung naiisip ng gobyerno na magsagawa at maglabas ng isang napaka overbroad, overvague, at saka ganyan draconian at democratic, lahat na pwede nating tawagin na anti-terror law, ang hirap paniwalaan na yun lamang ang kanilang objective.
The Philippine Bar Association, for its part, fears families and friends of designated terrorists might be affected.
What about the third parties, yung mga kaibigan nila na hindi naman talaga natatag na kasama sa mga organization, nirang sa mga listahan? Supposing may mga kapatid sila, may mga relative sila, subject to surveillance.
But Justice Undersecretary Adrian Sugay says safeguards are in place against possible abuses.
There will always be that issue, and I guess that's what the courts are there for. But in the meantime, Congress has determined that this is the way to go. This is the way to address an issue as pernicious and as urgent as terrorism. So it is what it is. It's what's in the law. And if the Congress determines it should be that way, it's really up to the courts, particularly to the Supreme Court, with regard to the current pending petitions for the against the Anti-Terrorism Act of 2020. The Congress exercised its prerogatives in a proper way.
Interior Secretary Eduardo Anyo, however, says there is a possibility those designated might be arrested if they have other pending cases.
Pwede silang huliyan para kasuhan sila po mali ng violation ng anti-terrorism law. No? Kasi iba naman kasi yung kanilang kaso na hindi naman sa violation ng anti-terrorism act. Eh. Yung iba din, illegal possession, iba ay rebellion. So ito, kami bagong kaso ito.
The lawyers of the designated terrorists are now studying their options. But even they are not aware of the basis for their client's inclusion in the list. Mike Navalio, ABS-CBN News.